Guys, welcome to KK Java tutorials. In this JUnit 5 tutorial, today we are going to discuss about dynamic test. We'll try to understand first of all what is dynamic test and related concept, and after that we'll jump to its implementation, right? So let's start. So guys, as you know, when we write standard test cases using add test annotation, then tests are static in nature, so that is fully specified at compile time, and their behavior cannot be changed by anything happening at runtime, right? So when you write a test case and you annotate as add test, then that is considered as a basically a static test, right? Let's say if you want to change its behavior at runtime, it is not possible, and that's the reason we require dynamic test. Yeah. Now, next point says dynamic test, which is generated at runtime by factory method that is annotated with add test factory. So one thing you have to keep in mind when you want to generate a dynamic test, then your test has to annotate it with add test factory. Yeah. Now, next point says a test factory method is not itself a test case, but rather a factory for test cases. Means if you write a dynamic test and you annotate as at test factory, that is not a single test, but that's a factory of test, right? Means factory of test, you can have a test inside a test, something like that. Now, next point says a test factory method must return a single dynamic node or a stream, collection, iterable, iterator, or array of dynamic node instances. So these are the basically return type of test factory method or dynamic test. Yeah, these things you have to keep in mind. Now, a test factory method must not be private or static. If you write a dynamic test, then you cannot make, once you annotate as a test factory, that method should not be private or static. Yeah, so this is the concept, but until unless we do not apply these things in any project, we do not understand each and every point, right? So here I have already created project, but one of the tests I'm going to implement from the scratch, but the rest of the one of the test case I'm going to implement from scratch, but the rest of the test cases already I have written, just to save some time, else this video will go so longer and will be reiterated, right? So let's I'm going to basically write a test case, basically a dynamic test, so that we can pass the stream of strings, and for every string we'll check whether that is palindrome or not. That's the use case I'm going to write. So here, as I said, if you write a dynamic test, that has to annotate with add test factory. So here you have to write test factory, and now as we talked in the slide, right, dynamic test can have a return type like stream, or you can have a collection of dynamic test. You have various return type, right? You can have a dynamic node, right? So here I'm going to take return type as stream, right? So it's a stream of dynamic node, right? Dynamic test, not node. Dynamic test. Yeah, now after that you have to specify the test method name. So I would say dynamic test for palindromes, right? Always you should give the meaningful test name. Yeah, now it is asking me for return type. As of now, just I'm going to add a return type, but here what I'm going to do, here I'm going to use a stream API, right? So I would say stream. I'm going to call a method is called off, right? There we can pass a lot of a string, right? So here I'm going to pass like pop, this is of course a palindrome, then I'm going to pass radar, then let's say mom, then let's say dad, and then let's say madam. All the strings are palindrome, right? And then I'm going to call a method is called map, right? So here I'm going to call this method is text mapper as an argument, right? So mapper is nothing but a functional interface, right? So here what I'm going to do here, here I'm going to write basically implementation of mapper or functional interface. So I write input text, right? So I write input text, and then after I'm going to write implementation of here just I write, and then after I'll explain you, right? So first of all, inside the map in processing, then I will write dynamic text. So I would copy from here. So map, and then after I would say input text, and okay, that's the mistake I have done. I was supposed to write input text. This is just a functional interface, right? So there is only one. I'd write now it should support. Okay. So I'd say input text, text. Then I'm going to write dynamic text. Yeah. That should be dynamic text. And here you need to specify the display name, right? So display name, I will write the input text itself. And then after, if you look into dynamic text, so this accept basically display name, and then you have to specify the implementation of executable, right? So that I'm going to specify. So let's say executable, and here I'm going to use assert true. And in assert true, I'm going to use myutils dot, I have written is palindrome, and here I'm going to pass the input text itself, right? So almost I have written the implementation. This little complicated, but once you understood that, it's easy to write. Basically, I think one more parenthesis is needed. Yeah. Now directly we can write return a statement here itself, right? That's it. So when you use your Stream API, then you can use basically method chaining. So let me break into different line. So here let me show you what I have written. I have written a stream.off. There I'm passing a lot of a string, right, to the stream, and I call the map method. So if you look in the map method, map has a functional interface, right, as an argument. So you have to write lambda for functional interface that I have written. So I have written lambda for functional interfaces, right? And here I'm using dynamic text. Dynamic text basically that takes first argument as display name, second argument as executable. Again, executable is a basically functional interface. So we have to write lambda for this, right? So I have written lambda for this. So this is nothing but the your display name, test case display name, and second is the implementation of this is the display name, test case display name, and this is the implementation of your dynamic test, right, or executable, you can say. And here I'm checking assert true. I'm passing each and every string, right? This will pass the each and every string. So if you have a five string, then five times your dynamic test is going to call assert true is going to call 5 times, and that is going to give you a test name would be the pop, radar, mom, dad, and madam, whatever is the word. And if that is the palindrome, then test case is going to pass for these words, else this is going to be fail, right? It's pretty simple. Let me run and show you. So if I run this test case, then here you can see the output. So here if I expand, here you can see the method name. Method name is nothing but the whatever method name is there, that's the that is coming. But look at the test case derived name, that is nothing but the whatever word, that is the display name I have given. So that's why pop is saying yes. Green color means every test case is going to pass, means all the words which is available here are palindrome. Let's say one of them is not palindrome. I am doing some manipulation, and if I run, then at this time this word is going to fail while checking the palindrome stuff, right? So here you can see this is now all the test cases has been passed, but this word is not palindrome, right? I hope you understood. Now let's let me run all the basically entire class, and let me show you each and every test case, right, what I have written. So first of all, one of the test case has been failed. So let me explain that one. So here guys, you can already we have discussed, right? So in first method here you can see return is basically this first method returns an invalid return type, and since an invalid return type cannot be detected at compile time, so JUnit exception is thrown when it is detected at runtime. So here you can see it is throwing JUnit exception, right? So this is clearly showing JUnit exception at runtime. So here return type is invalid we have given, and that's the reason it is getting filled. So intentionally I have written. Now let's go for the all the past test cases. So I am going to start from here. So if I click over here, then I reach to the test method, right? So here you can see how it is complicated, right? So this is one of the dynamic basically test case which returns a stream of dynamic node, and here you can see stream dot off. So there are three words I am passing, and of course I call the map method. Again, inside the map there is a implementation of functional interface, right? So here basically I have written dynamic container, right? Is container inside the container. So here method name would be the container, and just I am appending these words. So container A, B, and C. So here you can see container A, B, C, three test cases executed. If you expand that one, then inside that we have one assertion, right? Check for not null. So all these words are not null, right? So this all that is going to pass. Again, inside that we are having one another container which is basically checking the properties, right? And that is checking length of each and every word, whether length is greater than zero or not. And this assert false means this is not empty, right? So this guy will return false. So that's what we are using, assert false. And if you expand this one inside the properties, length greater than zero, that's the derived name. This is the name is coming as a derived name, right? And not empty, this is coming over here, right? So if you look at the dynamic test, so first is the display name, and second is the executable, right? So in similar fashion, that is executed, test case is executed for container B and container C as well, right? If we expand, similar derived name you get inside this, right? So that is all about this test case. Now let's move ahead. Now we have this test case, right? This is very simple test case, which basically again that returns a stream of dynamic test. I think already we have discussed, right? So this one we have written from the scratch, so I'm going to skip that one. Now we have another test case. So this is a test case, basically dynamic test case I have written, and which basically shows how we can write a dynamic test for given range of number. So here I am just getting even number, first five even number, right, using int stream, and assert to is checking whether these numbers are even or not, right? So look at the test display name, how it is coming. So test, then first even number would be 0, then 4. So in similar fashion here you can see test name has been derived, test 0, test 2, test 4, test 6 and test 8, right? All are even, so assert true is returning true. So all the test cases has been passed. Now if I look into the another test case, so here it's very simple. Again, return type is iterable dynamic test. So already we have discussed in the slide, we can also return, we can give the return type as iterable dynamic test. And here in this test, basically we have a two dynamic test, right? First is checking whether this passing string is palindrome or not. So here I have a utility class which is having few methods, like we are passing this input string and checking whether that is palindrome or not, right? So that's the code I have written. And I have a multiply method, which is basically taking two number and returning multiplication of these two number. And I have add method, which takes two numbers and returning addition of these two numbers, right? So here, of course, this is going to return true, assert true for first dynamic. And second dynamic test, this is just passing two numbers, checking whether this is returning multiplication of these two number equals to 9 or not. So of course, this is going to be passed. But here, look at the derive method name. Test name, right? So this is what we have hard coded, that is coming, right? Now let's go for the next dynamic test. So if I click over here, so this is the next dynamic, very simple. So here we have written, again we have a iterable and we have a two dynamic test. First is checking whether a string is palindrome, second is checking multiplication of these two number is 25 or not. So that is also getting passed. Now let's go to the next. Here we can also write a dynamic test which can return a single dynamic node, right? And here dynamic container name is palindrome, and that's what you can see over here, palindrome. If you expand this container, then there are four test cases, right? So this dynamic test is executed for each and every number, and we are passing over a checking whether these numbers are palindrome or not. And display name is whatever is the word or text which is coming as a display name, right? So pop, radar, mom and dad, all are palindrome. And that's what you can see, the test cases has been passed. Now next, so if I click over here, then it is pretty simple. So we can also give the return type as array of dynamic test, right? And here we have a two dynamic test, right? Given the name as seventh dynamic test and eighth dynamic test. And first is checking whether passing a string is palindrome or not using assert true. And second is passing, we are just passing, I'm passing 4, 4, and that returns the multiplication of these two numbers and checking whether equivalent to 16 or not. So this is also pass, 7th and 8th pass. Now let's go to the next. If I click over here, then again, what we have discussed in the slide, we can give the dynamic test return type collection of we can give the collection as well, right? And here also we have a two dynamic test. So I have given the display name as first dynamic test and second dynamic test. First dynamic test, we are checking whether given string is palindrome or not. And second, we are checking, we are just passing these two number of multiplication, 81 is or not. So this two test cases are also passing, right? You can see in the green color. And then finally, we'll talk about this one, right? So here, of course, when you write dynamic test cases, then you can return the single dynamic node as well, right? And we have directly written, when you have a single dynamic node, then directly you can write, you don't need to specify container, right? There is no meaning to specify container if you are writing only single dynamic test. And here I have given the name of dynamic test, right? And here we are checking whether mom is palindrome or not. This is passed as well, and this is failed already, we have talked, right? Because of the invalid return type, right? So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial, guys. So dynamic test is very good feature of JUnit 5 or JUnit Jupyter. So definitely you should use, if your test contains a lot of huge amount of input data, then writing a dynamic test would be basically a good choice, right? So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial. Still, you have any question, then you can post your question below to the video. I will try to answer. And as far as this source code concerned, this source code I'm going to post on my blog kkjavatutorials.com, and link you can get from the video description. Thank you.